Hey guys, it's Allie with Bold North Frenchies. So as you know, today is my Friday questions, and I have gotten asked this question so many times that I wanted to do a quick video about it, and it's really, really important. I know people have seen me talk about incubator and how we love our incubator, and I'm gonna kind of today tell you when we use the incubator and also maybe clarify some things, because we do not, the goal is not to have the puppies in the incubator all the time. The only time I would do that is if a puppy was sick. And like our last litter a few months ago, I had to have some completely isolated in one of our incubators to keep them away from the other puppies. However, just like with human children, the more time these puppies can spend and bond with mom, the better. For mom, because she needs to smell the puppies, to have them around, to hear them, in order for that bond to kick in, that oxytocin to kick in. So if you immediately separate puppies from mom when they get home, you're going to have issues, and you're going to make things a lot harder for yourself, because you're going to end up tube feeding or hand feeding, when really, once you get going and mom gets attached to the puppies and nursing, it's easy peasy. They latch on, she cleans them. I mean, it's a lot of just supervision, and mom will do a lot of it, but you need to give them the opportunity to bond, okay? So the time that we use the incubator, which I absolutely love having, is when I want a couple hours of sleep, because we don't, especially the first couple weeks, we do not leave mom and babies unattended, like at all. Not overnight, not to go to the bathroom, not to go upstairs and make food. We do not. In fact, if we all have to leave, which we rarely will, but if we do, we like to go to one of my kids' sporting events, which it's very rare we can all go at the same time. But if we try, I will have a puppy sitter come over here and just watch, sit in the whelping box and watch, especially that first week. Super, super important. I think the first 2 weeks are really key, okay? So if you want a couple hours of sleep at night, that's when the incubator is awesome, because we have a cot down there. We'll have mom come in bed with us and give her a little break from her babies, put the babies in the incubator for 2 hours. We'll set our timer or our alarm, and you know the babies are safe. You know they're in the perfect heat, humidity. It's just a really controlled, safe environment. And then when that 2 hours is up, we bring them back in the whelping box with mom and start nursing, okay? So that's when the incubator for us is really helpful. If I need to run up and take a shower, if I need to get a couple hours of sleep, that would be the time to use the incubator, okay? So I know everyone's gonna ask me, even though I've already shared this a bunch of times. So we have two incubators. And there's two options. You can either go for the more affordable option, and my friends at STB Kennels, they're on Instagram. I've referred a ton of people to them. Their incubators are around $500. I also have my huge Mac Daddy incubator, Pet Brooder 90, which I love as well, from True View Canine Reproduction on Instagram. So those are a couple options. You might, if you're just like casually breeding and doing like a few litters a year, I don't think you need to spend the thousands of dollars on the pet brooder. I think the STB Kennel ones is a great option. In fact, a lot of busy breeders use that incubator, but I like the size and the functionality. I can add my nebulizer to it. I can add more oxygen, all that kind of stuff to my Pet Brooder 90. So it's just a personal choice. But I just wanted to clarify that babies need to be with mom, please. I know it creates more work for you. You could just stick them like in the incubator all day and just bring them out to nurse. But eventually when they get over 2 weeks, it's just gonna be more work for you. It's just easier to get on a schedule. Mom bonding with babies as soon as possible. Okay, so have a great Friday, everybody. Talk to you soon.